What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry. It's been a very long time, I know. Last video I published was I didn't take note of that, but I think it was in late April. So it was basically wraps up our playlist that we did in Arc Object. So which I called it .NET programming with Arc Object, or then I changed the name to extending Arc Objects, because it's actually, this is the official naming by ASRI. So we were using an approach which is to build DLLs and extend ArcMap functionality using the extending arc object approach. It's pretty old approach, which has been, I don't like to say replaced, but it's actually being it's the new approach by Esri is add-ins. Esri add-ins. So as I was saying, I like to use the extending arc object approach because it gives you more flexibility and you can do almost anything you want with ArcMap when you are using this really tight approach with ArcMap, you know, as opposed to add-in. Add-in is actually simpler to build application. It allows you to build simpler, build application to own on top of ArcMap, but it's a very much simpler approach than the old one. But the extending arc object approach that we were using, basically, you have to define every single thing, you know, right? You have to define the grids, you have to define the toolbars, the commands, the add-in approach. These things are kind of there for you, you know, that a lot of things are backed, built in and ready to use for you, and that's why it's a bit much black box. You cannot really change it much, but it's becoming better and better, right? The good thing about the add-in approach is also that you can actually, it's more secure to build on top of using add-ins. The reason is that ArcMap knows when there's an add-in, as opposed to extending. When you build a project using extending arc object, you build a DLL and you register that DLL, and ArcMap just picks it up, you know. And that's kind of insecure, you know. It will not happen, but if someone writes like a virus and you register this DLL in your ArcMap, and ArcMap just picks it up and it will execute. Add-in kind of checks that, and it will ask you that, hey, there's a new add-in, do you want to enable that? Okay, so there's a layer of security. There are a lot of stuff, but anyway, this is not our topic today. Today, this video, or this audio, more likely, as I made this audio recorded to kind of just keep you guys in a loop and makes a channel update, like a kind of channel update. Yeah, this is my first channel update ever. So I was looking at the channel. There was no activity for a long time. So I just want you to know, guys, that I am still here. I didn't go away. I just a lot of stuff is currently happening with me, and they're pretty good things. So we're gonna discuss them in this video. All right. So the first thing is that the reason is I didn't make any videos and I didn't posted any episodes is that I was working actually on a new book. Okay, and the book is called, I'm not gonna reveal the name. I think the publisher didn't reveal it in the website yet, so, but I'm gonna tell you that it's a very exciting book. I've been working on it since the beginning of this year, and it is really, really, really exciting. So it's about arc objects generally. It's So it's an example approach. So the whole book is written, is pillared on, pivoted in three examples that I made up. You know, they don't exist in the internet. You cannot find them anywhere else. So the three examples, the first one is basically a simple, easy approach. The second one is a medium range difficulty. And the third one is actually like for advanced Arc object users. So each one example is a real life example. So because I have experience in a professional life, so I know how GIS projects really can tend to be. So I try to reflect this professional experience into a book, because you cannot find that. Most books are there as just references or documentation of existing APIs, and they just copy and paste stuff around from whatever they find from the. I don't like that. So what I like is I like to put things in context. So if there is a function I'd like to explain, I put it in within a context of where do you really want to use that for. Okay, so it's really very, very exciting book. Okay, and it's almost finished. It's gonna hit the market, I think, if the technical editing is done. It's gonna hit today is 29th of July, so by max end of August, I hopefully end of August or mid of August maximum. So it's gonna be very exciting books. I might do a contest to give away free books, as I did with my third book. So it's gonna be very exciting. So this is the first news. Okay, the second news is actually I'm leaving the country. As for those of you who are new to this channel, or I'm actually from Bahrain. So Bahrain is a little island near Dubai, near United Arab Emirates. Look it up, Bahrain, BAHRAIN. Okay, we host Formula One every year. Okay, so that's how people usually recognize us. So yeah, I'm from that island and I'm leaving the country. I found a new job. I've been hired by ESRI. So I'm moving to the United States. I'm moving to Redlands. I've been moving to Redlands in October this year. So I'm very, very excited to join the team. These guys are real geniuses. Real geniuses. When I got interviewed by them, you know, I really, really enjoyed every single interview. It was like, yeah, there was a lot of interviews, but yeah, I'm really, really proud and really excited to join ESRI. So my first assignment is actually in Abu Dhabi. I'm working with ESRI in a project in Abu Dhabi. So I'm gonna finish that up. And I am in Abu Dhabi, so I left my current job. I resigned and I'm in Abu Dhabi. They assigned me in Abu Dhabi here for 2 months. Once I finish up this project, I am going to head to the States. Yeah, my visa is almost done. Everything seems to be in order. So I'm very excited to make this huge change. So this is the first time I'm gonna move from the country. This is the first time to join a company outside, actually operating outside Bahrain. So that will be a very, very, very great experience. So me and my wife are moving. So this October. So wish us luck. And the third news is, yeah, so I'm not gonna stop, hopefully. I'm gonna keep making videos. I have a lot of ideas. So we wrapped up the first series. So I'm planning to do an advanced Arc object list or a playlist. So I'm gonna start a new series where we teach advanced Arc object stuff. So things that we didn't tackle in the first one. So we're gonna that of course include ArcSDE stuff. They don't say ArcSDE anymore. So it's Enterprise Geodatabase stuff. So ArcGIS Online most probably. Yes, we're gonna talk about a lot of stuff. So another thing I'm thinking about is actually to make a video about WCF, Windows Communication Foundation, and the communication with WCF and GIS. So how can you build services that consume Arc object, okay, and, you know, publish them on REST, you know, representational state transfer. So, and we're gonna explain, of course, about REST and SOAP and all this, you know, nice little topics. And we're gonna talk about SOEs then, after we finish the WCF, because actually SOE is nothing but a bunch of services hosted by ArcGIS server. So what's the benefit of using SOE as opposed to WCF? So we're gonna talk about a lot of stuff, really, really, really exciting stuff coming on. So guys, stay tuned, and this will be the end of the video. So I just thought I'd just keep you guys updated about what's going on in my life. So okay, stay awesome and goodbye.